What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 40 of the Ultimate Let's Play Dragon Quest. And I gotta admit right now, it's been about a week since I last recorded an episode, so I need to get familiar with where I am right now, so give me one second here. I did do some grinding off camera. I am now at level 35. I did learn a new attack called Kamikaze, which destroys all enemies but kills me in the process. And I gotta be honest with you, during one of my grinding sessions, I tried it out, and it didn't work, and I still died. So I'm probably not gonna be using that ability at all. Yangus got to level 34, didn't learn anything. Jessica is now level 33, and she finally learned Kaboom, which is the most powerful of the explosion spells. And then finally, Angelo, at level 34 now, he learned this. Kazing. 100% chance of resurrecting a fallen ally, and I believe it also restores him to full strength. So, Angelo is becoming a very vital part of this team. He's now my main reviver if I need him. And likewise, he also learned a couple new abilities. Sarcastic Sneer, which can reduce a single enemy's tension by one level. Good for some enemies. And then he also learned Angel Eyes, a powerful glance capable of paralyzing a single enemy. Could come in handy. So anyway, that's where we are. And if my memory serves me correctly, we are now back in the town of Baccarat. And we need to help out the duo of Cash and Carrie with their inheritance battle. We got a sneak peek of it in the previous episode. That much I still do remember. So why don't we head to the mansion and have a chat with them. So I don't know what kind of hell they're gonna drag us through. So let's just get this over with, I guess. Okay, so now I gotta find them. I think they're upstairs. If I can find the stairs. Oh, there they are right here. Alright, spill it. We're gonna have a little cutscene.
Let me explain the situation. Our foster father has passed away. Now, we're in the middle of deciding which of us will take control of his fortune. Maybe arguing is a better term. My sister and I are like oil and water. We never agree on anything.
Sibling rivalry.
That's why we've decided to have a trial. A contest, basically. Whoever completes it and returns to town first will be declared the winner!
The trial itself is a Golding family tradition. It's like a test of a potential heir's worthiness. All one has to do is enter the dragon graveyard and obtain the mark of the family on their hands. Sounds easy, right?
You mentioned the name Dragon Graveyard. Nothing about that sounds easy to me.
Nah! The Dragon Graveyard is full of monsters! We could even die, you know? So, we've agreed to hire bodyguards to protect us during the competition.
And let me guess, where are the bodyguards?
The only thing is, we haven't been able to find bodyguards of the right caliber. But I've got a good feeling about you, travelers. What do you say, little sister?
I hate to say it, but I agree. Wow, this is a first.
Hey, you finally agree on something.
Well, there you have it. Okay, then. If we're all in agreement, why don't you go ahead and choose which of our backs you'd like to cover? The loser will use bodyguards picked from the mansion staff. Won't you, Carrie?
Whatever. You're going down either way, Cash.
Sure, sis. Sure. Oh, and one more thing. You'll be compensated regardless of who wins. So, don't worry about pay.
So, I don't think it matters who you pick. You can pick either Cash or Carrie. Frankly, I don't like Cash's attitude, so I'm going to go with Carrie. Yeah, I will. Leave the first light tomorrow. Don't want you oversleeping, so you're going to crash here at the mansion tonight. Oh. Free lodging and a mansion. Sounds like a winner to me. But I think we're already healed up.
Fair enough. I'll take some of our men as bodyguards. And before I forget...
You rang?
Would you be so kind as to prepare a nice dinner for our guests tonight? We should do our best to put them on equal footing with the guards.
Don't you think? Do you always have to be so patronizing, Cash? But you won't hear me complaining about having a nice dinner.
You had me at dinner, let's go.
Diamond, first this scamper and now this. We're on a banquet roll.
King Trode's going to miss out again, though.
Well, what he don't know won't hurt him.
I won't tell if you won't. That evening, the party eat their fill of the delicious banquet laid out for them, then fall into a deep, contented sleep. Wish I could do that. Nobody calls me a lazy bum. Hey, I am a lazy bum, but come on.
What are you doing? The sun's already up. Cash is on his way to the cave.
Well, an alarm clock would have been nice.
I cannot believe this. Help me wake everyone up right now.
I'm already starting to regret picking you. And good luck waking him up. Just because I'm asleep.
Come on! Get up! Now!
Okay, I'm up.
I've decided to let it go this time because I overslept too. We have my jerk of a brother to thank for that. I got the maid to confess that she put sleeping powder in our food last night. Cash's order!
No wonder we slept so well.
Look, there isn't any time to discuss it now. We can still catch up with him. Come on! Let's go!
Already playing dirty.
I know you need to get yourselves ready, but I hate waiting around! So, I'm going on ahead. Meet me at the entrance to the Dragon Graveyard. And don't keep me waiting!
You know, I get the feeling we would have gotten screwed either way, depending on who we picked, so... I think picking Cash would have given us no difference, so... Let's just go and get this over with. Okay, as soon as I can find my way out of here, here's the door, let's go. So we're going to be heading off to the Dragon Graveyard. And hopefully maybe the casino will open up very soon. Don't know how much longer I have to wait until that place opens up. Because I believe you can get some good items in there, especially in the Baccarat Casino, yeah. Alright, anyways, time to leave Baccarat behind. And head to the Dragon Graveyard. So let's have a look at our map. So I believe that the Dragon Graveyard is in the desert at the southern tip of this continent. That giant arrowhead at the southernmost point of the continent that we're on right now. Okay. So I think the best way to get there is sea. So where did I park my boat? Am I heading the right way? No, I've got to head this way. First, we're going to get some battles out of the way here. I wonder if we can just run from these guys. I don't feel like dealing with them right now. I just want to get to the boat and get to the damn place. And these guys are pretty easy enough to run away from. And if we saw our boat in the distance there. Really get attacked right before I get on. Alright, let's just make quick work of these guys. Let's show off Kaboom here. Maybe a little swoosh as well. Actually, screw it, we'll use a Shining Shot. Nice critical hit there. I'm guessing I wasted MP with this move. I was expecting D'Angelo to go last. Alright. Time to set sail. So we're just going to follow the western coast of the continent. And get attacked by enemies on our boat. King Squids. These guys should be easy enough to handle now. These guys still have a lot of HP, I think. And they have overestimated my abilities. It will take down one in a single round. These guys aren't doing too much damage. Just a single round of attack should be enough here. Even Jessica's doing some decent damage with the staff. I'm actually doing triple digit damage with a normal attack now. It shows you how powerful we've gotten. Unfortunately, these guys are not going to be giving up too much experience, so I'm going to try and conserve my MP the best I can. Checking my map here to see if I can find any spot to dock. You know what, I'll put on Holy Protection for now, just so I can concentrate on this. Hopefully the Holy Protection will work. I'm going to want to move quickly through this, so I'm going to go ahead and summon Balmrin. Just to make this go a little quicker. That's right, I have it in inventory now. Okay, now you get a rough idea of where I am. I see a little building, like, right at the entrance of the, desert there, so I wonder. Maybe it's a spot I can maybe rest or something. the signs say? Desert area. Okay, this is probably going to be where we need to go. Alright. When we head into the desert, the sandstorm's starting to kick up a bit. And I see there's a little chapel here. So let's go inside and have a look-see. This is a spot where you can also save as well. I see an item shop and an inn here. Okay. This is a cheap rate. Cheapish, I guess. Now let's see what this item shop has. Didn't mean to talk to him again. I want to see what items we have for sale here. Maybe they got magic water, I don't know. No, but they have a dream blade. Yeah. You know what, I'll grab a few of these Amorcico essences. They're starting to become a little bit more useful to have than the herbs. Alright. And I believe I can actually get something by talking to this big dude here. A weapon called a sandstorm spear that kicks up a cloud dust and blinds your enemy. Make it by mixing a partisan spear and something really dry like sand. So he gives us a new recipe to make a sandstorm spear. Partisan spear plus something gritty. I want to do a quick divination, see where I stand in terms of experience. 28,000, 20,000, almost 24,000. 26,000, so we got a long ways to go before our next level ups. So, not gonna save, we're only 17 minutes into recording here. So, we're gonna keep going here. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and ring up Bomren here. And get moving. Big desert. Alright, so. Now, my notes say if I go straight east, I should come across a treasure chest. There goes my holy protection. Let's see what enemies inhabit the desert. Muddy hands, lethal armor, and some death scorpions. Ooh. A lot of enemies. A lot of enemies needs a lot of experience. Luckily I got a lot of attacks that hit all enemies, so might as well go to town on these guys. Wow. Almost a strike there, Angela. Nice. See a treasure chest all the way up to the side. Let's see what's in here. I see a well over there. Got a piece of dragon dung. Well, we hop in the well and see what's down here. You can go into a lot of wells in the Dragon Quest series. I see a giant tornado down here. What happens if I go in? See. I think it seems to have teleported us. There's a treasure chest right here. What do we got in here? We got a dragon scale. Okay. Well, I guess we should start making our way to the middle of the desert. That's probably going to be where the graveyard's going to be. So, let's just nuke these guys. These guys are actually going down pretty easily. It's kind of surprising and a little disappointing, to be honest with you. Maybe I did more leveling up than I intend to do. Alright. That big cave there. I wonder if that's an enemy, that glowing thing. Dancing flames, must be. Haven't seen these guys in action yet, so let's see what they bring to the table. Seem to go down easy enough. They're barely hitting me at all, but then again, I got that dragon shield, which protects me from fire and cold. Good job, Yangus. Alright. And that's all she wrote for that one. You know what? I can use a challenge before I go in. Or maybe not. Get a cutscene.
Man, where have you guys been? I was starting to think you'd never show up.
It's a big desert. Give me a break.
Cash is already inside. We've got to go after him. I've got to win. I swear, Cash, I'm going to have you begging for mercy.
I'm just going to go right in. We're not even going to bother taking out that other enemy outside. Okay, so let's go in and have a look here. Get that torch again. So, let's see. I'm wondering if I can find... Well, I see a treasure chest over here. Maybe this is the map. And looks like we have Carrie with us as well. We gotta map the Dragon Graveyard. Okay. So let's have a look. Alright. Seems like a pretty straightforward path. Okay. Right, we're gonna get into battle. Looks like Carrie's not gonna participate. We got three Dragurus or Dragurns. I was gonna read that for a second. Anyways, let's give him the usual treatment here. Make it rain, Angelo. Make him see the light. Now I have a little light of my own. Still standing. That goes down to an axe attack. Okay, that did some damage. Okay, Cracker should finish them off, though. Finish one of them off. One manages to live. We'll just use normal attacks on it. And now I got that auto heal equipment on as well. Okay, now this looks like it's going to be kind of a bit of a maze here. And took a wrong turn. I don't know if I can go across these bones or not. Beelzebubs. Beelzebuzzes. Just waste his turn there. Fry him up, Jessica. didn't do as much as I thought it would. Survive a sword attack there, yet they're just wasting their turns. So why don't we strike while the iron's hot here? Again, just wasting his turn. He's basically asking us to kill him. I'm more than happy to oblige. Got the business end of the moon axe. Looks like I can go over these bones here. I think I want to get to the, I'm guessing southwest corner here. Well, there's two exits here. I think this path is actually going to take me further into the dungeon, so I'm actually going to go this way and check that other path first, so I'm curious to see what is over there. Yeah, this is a definite maze here that we're going through. There. Luckily, he could take a hit or two. And they fall to my zap attack. Okay, now. It's just a lot of back and forth here. Okay, so if I keep going straight this way, it should take me to an area where I see a treasure chest. All by its lonesome. Next to a bunch of bones. And in here, we got a mini Mel, so I think it was definitely worth the trip. So let's backtrack and take the other exit. Take down two more of these guys. I'm gonna try and conserve some magic here. Although, Jessica can burn through a bit of hers, because she can obviously recover it. And we do got plenty of magic waters and elf and elixirs, I believe, as well, so not too worried right now. Alright, down to a 4-on-1 assault here. Kaboom! Blew him up. Oh boy. That did a lot of damage. I mean, Yangus and I could take it, but not so much with Jessica and Angelo. Okay, you need to die now. I'm surprised that guy outsped us there. Okay, so wanna do a quick heal. Okay, we should be okay now. It's a good thing I have a discount with spells. Let's make sure I'm going the right way here. Okay, it gives me the path to go, but depth perception is another story. Sometimes I don't think I'm there, and then I'm there. Otherwise, I'm waiting forever to get to where I want to get to. Still standing after that. Wow. This play didn't use that blazing fire attack. So let's focus on taking that guy out first. Actually, I'll take that guy out myself, but whatever. As long as I'm going to use that blazing fire, I'm good. And that should be the finishing blow from Angelo there. Okay. Now, again, getting my bearings here. It's going to go right through this pathway to the next part of the dungeon. Okay, now. Tyrannosaurus, new enemies. These guys look fierce. I think they're all in a group, so I can probably make quick work of them. I'll just swoosh instead. Swoosh definitely did a lot of damage. Oh, jeez. I take too many of those, and we're in trouble. Three down. And this should be number four. And down they go. Guess we need a decent experience out of those guys. I'll just have Angelo do a multi-heal. Okay, so nothing down here, it's a dead end. This one here first. I think I see something like a bag on a wall there. I'm gonna go ahead and grab that as soon as I take these guys out. Fire, that's fine by me. Alright. Now let's see what's in this bag. Got a piece of dragon dung. So I think we now have to go back. Go back across that bridge. So we're using these skeletons as bridges. How morbid is that? Oh geez, more of these guys. We gotta take them out quickly, so let's just go all out. These guys are attacking first. Boom's definitely effective. Okay, one more. Again, I wasted MP. One that I could use for multi-heal potentially. Alright. So now we'll go across this bridge. So I think I just need to make my way to that top right corner and just follow the map, I guess. I don't think there's any other treasures here, so I'm just gonna start making a beeline for the exit. Right through this little tunnel here, this little rib cage. I got a couple smackers, a new enemy. Just use zap. Axes of evil. Kaboom. Angelo, I want to conserve your power there, so I'm just going to have you do a normal attack out of Dragoon. And I don't think those smackers are really posing any kind of a threat. So we should finish off at least three of these guys. As I expected, just one Dragoon left. Dragoon left. I'm just finish him off normal attacks. Yangus just needed one swipe of the Moon Axe. Alright, now, where am I? Just gotta finish getting through this pathway here. And now we're in another new room. More bones. Okay, so Cash is definitely ahead of us. I'm gonna deal with these smackers, but they're too stunned to move. I will spare their lives. Again, you gotta pick your battles. And I didn't mean to go into there, I wanted to check my map. Somehow I ended up all the way over there. That's a dead end. Such a maze. Alright. So I can go down this way. Oh, sweet Jesus. I'm gonna shut up for now and just try and kill this guy. And he runs away first chance he gets. That was the ultimate taunter, as my boy Hunter P. Brown says. Mother load of experience for beating that guy. If you can actually hit him. But anyways, I think there's something here we can get. Indeed there is. A dragon shield, another one of these things. Problem is, can anyone equip it? I mean, Yangus and I already have it, and unfortunately Jessica and Angelo cannot use it, so... Well, that's unfortunate. Anyways, now I think we're coming up on a boss here soon, so... I don't know how much more ground I have to cover before I get there, so let me just use my herbs to heal up. I think only... Yangus needed a bit of a kick there. As we go through here... Now where are we? I really have no clue where I am. Don't waste my time. Okay. So this was the one way to go. Alright. Now that I'm out here, Just go under this overpass. Through this dragon's mouth. More enemies. This way. Okay, then just go into another dead end. Guess I go across this. We must be near the end here. Alright, I think we're ready. Let's go in. It's like some kind of a dungeon. Oh boy, these guys are in trouble. There's Cash.
Cash? Whatever, Cash. You made your bed. This is what you get for being a cheater. Now you're monster food.
Come on, we gotta save them.
But if you cry for help, like a little baby, I might have my men give you a hand. What do you say?
Oh.
Cash? Are you listening? Quit playing around and answer me before it's too late.
He looks like he's seriously hurt, Carrie. We gotta help him. One hell of a shot there.
Carrie, what are you doing here?
Yeah, these guys need our help. She's out cold. Cash is clinging to life. All right. And it's boss time against Red Horn and Blue Fang. So these guys are probably going to be really tough here. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and start psyching up both me and Angela. Actually, Yangus, you use Kabuff on us. Jessica, if you could give us a little bit of a speed boost. Angelo, see if you can fuddle them. Or you can only fuddle one. You know what? Double up on the kibosh. Let's get defense up and running before we start doing anything major here. So I got a feeling these guys can hit pretty hard. Just look how fierce they look. Red Horn going for an attack. Does 88 damage to Jessica. Blue Fang going after Angelo, doing a bit of damage himself. And that was with the kibosh in place. Yeah, we gotta be careful. Okay, so me and Yangus will continue to go up there. Let's see if Jessica can get a couple of attacks in. I'll have Angelo use multi-heal. Okay. And he gets a little bit of power boost back. Ouch, that did a lot of damage. I'm gonna try and negate her buffs there. Okay. Well, I can heal myself, so you don't have to worry about healing me, Angelo. I'm gonna continue to psych up, as will Yangus. Jessica, keep hitting him with a kaboom. And let's have Angelo get that kabuff back on us here. Can't hit high tension. I wonder if I should try one more. Coming at us. Hits Yangus. Okay, that's fine. Oh, he's gonna psych himself up. I think this is where Angelo can use Sarcastic Snigger to try to negate that, so I'll have him use that move. I'm gonna try one more time. The Yangus psych up again. Maybe try... Nah, just keep... I'm not gonna go with the Puff Puff. Let's just go with the Kaboom. Angelo will use Sarcastic Snigger on Red Horn to negate that tension. Hopefully you can get the attack off before Red Horn actually attacks. Alright. Well, that'll reduce his tension to zero. I couldn't get to level 100 tension there. Glad that was all that took there. So Angelo, I think Jessica's gonna need a little bit of help here. Alright, so Yangus, time for you and me to go ham on this guy here. Falcon Slash, and you hit him with a Helm Splitter. Jessica, keep going with Kaboom. Angelo will do some healing. Actually, you can just use me to heal. Okay, let's see what kind of damage Yangus and I can do here. Helm Splitter does 363 and does decrease defense. So maybe my Falcon Slash can do quite a bit of damage, maybe? 809 combined. Beautiful. I think that probably wiped out about half of his HP there. That single attack. And that stunned me and Yangus. Luckily, we got our attacks off there. We're going to have to sit this turn out, unfortunately. Alright, so... Jessica, let's just keep going at it here. Keep using Kaboom. And, Angelo... Angelo, you know what? Hit him with a Shining Shot. Since we can't attack, maybe you can. What kind of damage you can do with that. Not bad. I'll go after Jessica there. Gonna try and use Cassette to reduce her defense even more. I think we're gonna focus on Red Horn here. I'll just use Falcon Slash. Actually have Yangus use Kabuff again. Jessica, keep going at him with Kaboom. Angelo, just use mid-heal on Jessica. I want to keep everybody alive at full power here. And I know they have a desperate attack, which could potentially kill us in one shot, so I'm going to try and take these guys out before they unleash that attack on us. I don't know. I think Red Horn has maybe ballpark 3,000 hit points. I'm not entirely sure exactly what the actual number is. I think Blue Fang, slightly less. I'm trying to play a little defensively, though. Alright, so I'll give him a zap attack. Give him a helm splitter. Kaboom. And I'll let Angela multi-heal this go around. Still standing, wow. Giving Angus a pummeling bear, he can take it. He's a tough guy. I'm gonna start shifting focus to Blue Fang as well. I think we're getting doing pretty well in terms of getting these guys worn down. These guys can take a walloping here. Oh, here's the desperate attack. Yikes, that did a lot of damage to Yangus. And that probably could have killed Jessica in one shot there. So luckily I got that attack off in time. I think Yangus will need a full heal here, Yangus, or Angela. Yangus needs the full heal. Okay, he's back to full health here. I'll get from this Red Horn psyching himself up again. I don't know how close he is to death or not. I know he's a lot closer to death than Blue Fang. So let's focus on him before he takes us out. And just as a precautionary measure, we'll try a sarcastic snigger. Alright. Light him up, Jessica. And Red Horn is down. That's one. Now we can focus solely on Blue Fang. So I'm going to start preparing an onslaught. I switched to using Frizzle. You keep healing us, Angelo. I know you're running a little low on magic, but it's down to just him now, so this should be a little bit easier to manage now. Get some extra offense in while we can. Okay, let's start to come up because it is wearing off. I think this battle's gotten a lot easier now. We're down to just him, because it also wiped out his tandem attack with his partner there. Keep going. Maybe I should have used the buff. But we'll see what happens. Okay, he's gonna try and brace himself for an attack here. I'm gonna try this one more time, see if either me or Yangus can hit level 100 tension. See if you can sap him. And Angelo, get that kebuff on. Just in case. Now he can't go any higher. No, huh? There is a level 100 tension, but I have yet to hit it at any point in this LP, and I'm a little disappointed in that. Alright, well, we tried once, I'm not gonna chance it again. Time to go all out. You know what? You actually use a Caduceus on Angelo. Let's have Angelo get a couple shots in. Don't use Shiny, I'll use Blinky Shot. And good that he got the Helm Splitter off first, because that'll reduce the defense. And down goes Blue Fang. We win. A lot of gold, a lot of experience, but no level up.
Oh, sis. How could this happen? But I won't forget your sacrifice, Carrie. Not for as long as I live. Don't you worry. I'll take over Dad's place and make you proud. I know you and Dad will be watching over me from heaven.
Well, she's definitely not dead.
Sorry, Cash, but I'm not dead yet.
Ow! Hey. So you're okay? I should have known better than to worry about you.
You big fat cheater! I cannot believe you mixed sleeping powder in our food! You just threw the contest as far as I'm concerned. And look what happened! You nearly got yourself killed! You're lucky I found you in time!
Look, I'm sorry. I just really wanted to win. To finally make you respect me as an older brother. But you know what? I don't care anymore. You risked your life to save me. You deserve to become the sole heir.
Huh? Like, what are you saying?
It looks like he surrenders.
I'm saying the fortune's yours. And let's make that the end of this stupid rivalry between us. Anyway, we're almost at the doors of judgment. Bodyguards, we're still counting on you.
All right, well. Is this the way we need to go? I guess so.
All I have to do is open these doors, and the family crest will be marked on my hands. Owie! Ow!
Old Home Alone trick, burning your doorknob.
What's up with this door? It's all hot. I'm so going to get burned.
Well, duh. The burn is the mark of the family heir. Why do you think they're called doors of judgment? You can't stand the heat. Get out of the kitchen.
Wait. So I have to open both of these doors? I can barely get the one open. It's impossible to do alone. Whatever. Guess there's only one thing to do. If you feel sorry about that dirty trick you pulled, now's your chance to make up for it. Help me open the doors. If you do, I'll agree to split the fortune. That means we'll own the casino together. Deal?
You won't hear me complaining. But don't come crying to me if you start regretting it later.
Come on. That side's all yours.
Let's do it.
Stronger together, Carrie. Stronger together.
What are you crying about? This is nothing compared to getting smacked upside the head by a monster.
Well, where are you going to be feeling it for a while to come?
I'm not crying. I just want to get back home and put some ice on my hand.
Not until after we go in and have our audience with our ancestor.
Bodyguards! You'd better come too. We're not done here yet.
Are you sure? Because I've been recording for an hour now. I kind of want to get this wrapped up here. Anyways. Alright, well, let's see what this thing is. Master Golding.
Well done, child of my children's children. You have reached the inner sanctum. In so doing, you have completed the trials and proven your worthiness as heir. Now, hearken to my words. Noble blood courses through your veins. As a trusted descendant, you have an obligation to protect this noble heritage. You may never permit this bloodline to end, for whilst it endures, the world shall remain at peace.
Well, Golding was a descendant of one of the sages that sealed away Rapthorn.
That was our ancestor?
Sure looks that way. That crystal seems to be enchanted with some sort of power that shows an image to us.
He said not to let the bloodline die out, but isn't that impossible? We were adopted, after all.
And technically, Golding was killed, so the bloodline's already dead, if you ask me.
The family bloodline ended when Father was killed.
Well, we can't do anything about that now. All we can do is work together to make the casino even more successful. Anyway, we've heard what he had to say. Let's go home. And don't forget, travelers, you're still on the payroll as bodyguards until we get back.
Alright, well, looks like our business is done here. Let's go home. Or at least, out of the dungeon. Or if we're going to be sent all the way to Baccarat. I'm going to take that music as a sign that it's yes. Go back in Baccarat.
What happened? What are you two doing together?
Does this mean you still don't know who won?
Come on, it's obvious. It must have been a draw.
Does this mean the casino's gonna stay closed? Give me a break.
Listen up, all of you. As you can see, the contest was a draw. However, an heir has been decided.
Both of us are inheriting our father's fortune. Together.
And as proof, we have both obtained the mark of the Golden Clan from the Dragon Graveyard.
I just wanted to hear that fanfare. I love that.
They look just like the scars Golding had on his hands. Yeah, He used to show them off all the time down the pub, he did.
We also have some good news for everyone. The casino will reopen tomorrow!
Hallelujah, I've been wanting to check that place out. Maybe I'll do a whole episode dedicated to that, I don't know.
Yes! Ooh, yes!
I mean, we're here, we might as well.
About bleeding time!
And finally, we need to thank you for protecting us, my traveling friends. But we're exhausted at the moment. We'd like you to stay in the mansion tonight as our guests, so we can properly reward you tomorrow.
You'll save us a hotel fee, so yeah, we'll take you up on the offer. Looks like this episode is going to stretch out a little bit longer. Cash and Carrie want to talk to us. They're downstairs, if I can get downstairs. And we slept well. Good, you're gonna work together now. So we get free casino tokens. Alright, so 600 to start. So that's gonna be our seed money, I guess, for the casino. So, yeah, I think we'll check out that casino in the next episode. What, another casino? Come on.
Well, there they go. I guess this is goodbye.
You know, before we met them, I never imagined things would turn out like this. I mean, both of us inheriting Dad's fortune? Who would have believed that? Looking back, I can't believe how stubborn we were acting about being sole heirs. It's amazing how easily people can change when they put their minds to it.
Watch it there, big brother. This talk of becoming sole heir, it's freaking me out.
Don't worry, I'm not suggesting anything. We're in this together, I swear. On the mark on my palm.
I swear it too, Cash. On the mark of our family. And on the memory of our father. Now that we're working together, we can make the Golding family more successful than it's ever been. Let the good times roll.
Well, I hope your casino business turns out very well, and I'm sure Father would have been proud of you. All right, time to finally put this episode to bed. I want to get out of here. I believe we're already healed up as it is, right? Let me just double check. Yep, we're fully healed. Okay, so yep. At this point, we are finally done. I can go ahead and finally save. So yep. We finally got the casino open, something I've been waiting all game for. I'm not going to spoil anything about it right now, but I will say that there is a couple of items that are prizes over there that will be invaluable, and there's one I really want to get. But for now, I've been recording well over an hour after me to call it quits and put this episode to bed. So next episode, we'll have a look at the casino. Until next time, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.